Oh, we're on an item. Security card class C. Awesome. Can you carry this too? Just for the hell of it, I want to analyze it. Because I analyze everything. Okay. Alright, I need to put the trap thing back on. Trap sensor. Oh. Nothing special. Another item. Oh. More nunchaku. We have those though. I mean, I hope we can sell things at some point. Kinda care if it's better than the knives. Oh, he dropped that. Is that... Oh, did he not drop that? I thought that was his. I thought that was his tiger claw. Wait a second. So, yeah, okay, we have nunchucks, and tiger claws, and we have throwing stars. That's pretty sweet. Do they run out, like, ammo? Like, can you throw them, like, twice or something like that? I don't know how that works. Yeah, give him that, too. More throwing stars? Alright. I gave the other ones to Advent. Nothing else there. I want to analyze these... drawing stars here. This sounds like complete chaos all around. Minimal work value requires dexterity. Average wounding is 14. Range is 8. Alright, I want to write stuff down here. Because I'm not good at just memorizing crap like this. The throwing stars. Let's see. We've got. The Psy classes plus Assassin can use it. And then wounding is 14. Range attack plus 55%. That seems important too. As I'm trying to determine what's the best thing to have. This needs to be his active weapon. Well, he still does have 7 rounds left. That's true. I always forget. I have some kind of mental block with thinking Advent's completely out. Tiger claws are better. They require the same amount of dexterity. But of course, the range is 2. You have to get right up to the opponent. Oh, that's interesting. I mean, I guess when he runs out of the, when he runs out of his ammo, he can use the ninja stars. I just don't know how many times you can use them. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna pick them up again, or it would be stupid if they come, like, if it's unlimited, like you have like boomerang ninja stars. Alright, so the other Varanus, we gave him the stars. He's got that and the nunchaku. I want to see how much that does. That's another physical thing. Melee weapon. It's the same as the... It requires more, better stats here, but it's the same. It's 18 and 2 range. It's got a few more modifiers. Yeah. Alright, I don't know. Alright, so this is the stuff they were looting. This store holds equipment and machinery of very remarkable value. More stuff. Moonclaw's turn. Ooh. Heavy ribbed armor. More than one of them, I think. Oh, this is gonna... Yeah, he can't carry it. Oh, it is just one. Analyze. kilograms. Speed factor 160%. Almost everything, everyone can use it, but we need 60 strength to wear it. Mediator, psionic. Knight, mercenary, assassin. So the only one who can't use it is the anchorite. Physical protection plus 30. Range action time. Brings your endurance down. So, with these things, you can always give it to. Like, I could give it. Well, Runeclaw can't even carry it unless. That music just drives me insane. Moonclaw can't even carry it unless he carries something else. So I'm torn between, well, give it to the character who's going to be, like, fighting a lot, and give it to protect the character. Like, maybe Varanus could use it, since his stamina is so low. Speaking of low, we gotta rest. What is it? It requires a strength of 50, I think it said. So he's got enough strength. Ah, Runeclaw does not. So I don't have an option with him. But I would give it to Varanus. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Maybe he won't get hit so much. Dwindling down his tiny little stamina. Automatically. Was he wearing both? Wait, this is the heavy armor. Okay, he's wearing the uniform tunic over the armor. He has combined light armor. Okay. Well, we'll switch this to... Wait, where is it? Switch this to the heavy ribbed armor. Ah! You have not enough strength to operate that item. Strength is currently 51. I thought it said 50. Oops. Sixty. I was wrong. Alright. I was wrong, man. Well, the more you know. So, there are a few other people who can't have it. Killdozer can wear it. Epsilon can wear it. Twin Snake can wear it. I don't know if he has to rest first. Oh, Runeclaw 3. And Advent cannot wear it. So the only ones who can wear it are Twin Snake, Epsilon, and Killdozer. What do they currently have on them? Let's see. Well, we need to switch this back. He'll wear the combined line on. It's curious, because I don't think we've even seen this on anyone. They probably all have it under, whoever has a tunic has it under them. Or whatever this is. Yeah, uniform tunic. I didn't realize they had armor on underneath that. They all have these tunics. Alright, before I put it back on him, let's analyze it. Because I was not aware of the existence of this. Young thought they're running around just with tunics on, no wonder they're dying so quickly. 4.40 kilograms, all classes can use. It just has physical protection plus 10%. Alright, some resistance modifiers here. Stab wounds more than anything else. Alright, so now we put it there. And we put the tunic over it. So make sure I didn't remove it. And who's the lucky one who gets it? Out of two people, right? Epsilon. Killdozer. Or Twin Snake. Basically, I'm going to give it to whoever has the most stamina and, like, well, the least stamina and vitality. So he has 137, 108, 141, 92. 137.95. I think it slows you down a little bit. He's so fast. We might as well give it to Epsilon. He's still gonna be fast as hell. I think it might slow him down a little bit. Oh. Yeah, thank God, no battle situation. Equipment. Alright, so we will take... Let's just put it here first, and then I can confirm. Yeah, they're wearing, oh, elite troop armor. Oh, look at that, like, skull, face, whatever, head on it. Let's see how much the elite troop armor is. Yeah, guys, I know I'm digging forever doing all this stuff. I just like to analyze and see the stats and all that. It is a lot of stats. I'm not sure how much I'm getting out of it. Only knight and mercenary can wear it. Physical protection plus 20. And the following modifiers. It was really good against radiation and pressure. Ooh, and stab, cut. Hit wounds, shot wounds, it's pretty good. And, so wait a second. This might be better than the armor we're looking at. I mean, those resistances are better. Hold on a second. Physical protection is plus 20%. It's not good against electricity. I guess it's metal, so it conducts electricity, maybe more? So now compare this. Physical protection is plus 30 on it. And these modifiers are pretty good though, but even worse against electricity. So this is an improvement. Now that we got that clear though, I don't know. This one, only two classes can use. Knight and Mercenary. Mercenary? Which one is our mercenary? Mercenary is Twin Snake. So Twin Snake can also use that, but he's the only other one in this group who can. But is that what he currently has? What is that? It said, well, there's no... Okay, he's got military armor. Isn't that different? He's got elite troop armor. And he's got military armor. All these different kinds of armor. Bunch of people can use that. Everyone except for Anchorite, which would be Advent. Physical protection plus 15%. The other one's 20. So I say, yeah, hand down. I could be wrong. I mean, there's a lot of values, like miscellaneous protection things. Maybe some armors will be better with that. But I say put that there. Have him wear the heavy ribbed armor. And then the... the tunic. We have the elite troop armor. I still check to make sure it didn't take the other armor off. Okay, so we're wearing it over it. Oh, there's little buttons here! Oh, he's got uniform trousers! He's got a combat helmet. Oh, with a hood underneath! Oh, this is getting complicated. Alright. Well, there's no more plates left for that item. Oh wait, no. That's right. I forgot what I was doing. I was giving this to Twin Snake. Wait a second. Oh Okay. And now his tunic. It's a weird way of working this system here. I mean, I can understand it. Just okay, so now he's got this armor underneath. What about these trousers? Do they provide any protections? I just noticed those arrows. That's insane. It does help a little with physical protection and temperatures and stuff. Okay. I approve. So we got boots and trousers. And we got a helmet and a hood. So the hood, I guess, provides some minimal protection on top. I would think, like the trousers do. I actually wonder what else I haven't noticed. All classes, yeah. Yeah, it helps a little bit. Oh yeah. All this stuff adds up. Because I had taken off the hood of someone and given them a helmet. See, Killdozer is only wearing the hood. Huh. And we had picked up an extra helmet. He's got the trousers. He's got military armor. Okay. Let's look for another helmet. Because that's what I just gave him. Every little bit helps. So wait, can I do that with the... Can I reload that? Weapon is not empty yet. Do you want to load it anyway? I'm gonna say no. I don't wanna... This is plus 20. I mean, what happens? I'm just gonna save. Yeah, we're into the next game. The next video. Okay. Alright, so we've got 20 there and 6 there. So, yes, I've loaded the weapon, I understand. I got 20 here. The rest of the ammo is gone. I lost the 6 bullets, or 6 rounds, whatever. Okay, so that's why I did that. That's exactly why I did that. So. Now we have his ammo. And we have, okay, so we can't load the gun until it's empty. I mean, I don't think it even takes an action round to do that, so it's not that big of a deal. Yeah, he has a steel combat helmet and the hood over. More of these trousers. That's the armor I just gave him, and down from Epsilon. light armor. Desert hood. There we go. Now we got the hood and the helmet. He's just got a hood, no helmet. Advent has a hood, no helmet, same trousers, combined light armor. Could use one of those gloves. So I could put this in the other hand. You have not enough dexterity to operate that item. Oh, that's sad. I should take that away from him then. Oh, he can't even operate the tiger claws. Excuse me, his dexterity 26. Is it current dexterity or all? You know. Let's see. Requires 30 dexterity. And he has 27 or something. Six. Oh, well, that's sad. Need to go up in dexterity somehow. Everyone else is fine. So if I go like this, just to put it... You need both of your hands to use this weapon. Oh, that's not. Need both your hands for this weapon? Sorry, you're already using a two-handed weapon. Oh. That's a two-handed... Oops. That's a two-handed weapon, this thing? I guess so. That's a two-handed. Yeah. Well, he needs one of those glove things, too, then. But we haven't found any of those. We need to find ammo is what we need. We keep finding this stuff. That's a two-handed, right? It's the same thing? Yeah. Okay. So he's got the throwing stars in this hand and he's got the shotgun in this hand. He can't use it. Yeah. So might as well give it to Varanus? Oh. select. Okay, because I don't know how the throwing stars work. So, I don't know if you throw them twice and that's it, you get them back at the end of the battle. I have no idea, so. I don't know how many there are. Doesn't say. Let me look again. See if there's any, like, quantity or something. Because everything else says how much it had, how many, rounds or whatever equivalent for throwing stars. Don't say anything. Okay. I think we're done. I was looking. Someone else had a helmet. Or did I already get that? Was that the helmet I was thinking of? Let's see. He doesn't have it. Or an extra hood. I think it was just that hood. I found someone a helmet, so I took the hood off and put the helmet there, not realizing you can have a hood, you can wear a hood and a helmet. Yeah, that must have been what it is. Okay. Oops, that was the one that was here. All right. That was a lot of stuff. I'm gonna save. I'll forget what the hell I did with all this. Back for that door. Oh, this just circles around. And this is the way down, right? Yes. Alright, we are here. We'll try the security card next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.